Coco nuts. I swear I get asked questions about coconut nearly every single day. I guess you could say people are nuts about coconut, which is why today I want to sit down with you and really talk coconut, which parts you can eat, which parts you should avoid, and who, if anyone, should skip coconut entirely. And if you haven't been with me for long, you may be surprised, because there's one controversial part of the coconut that I'm actually a huge fan of, and one supposed health food I'm about to tell you to avoid. But before I get into all that, let's talk about the people who shouldn't eat coconut. Because it's true, coconut isn't for everyone. Obviously, if you've got a proven coconut allergy, steer clear. But keep watching this video because I'll share substitutes for some popular parts of the coconut. And if you've got a tree nut allergy and aren't sure about whether coconuts are okay for you, please steer clear. They may be giant, but they're still a true tree nut, and as such, they'll set off some people's nut allergies. Now, no matter who you are or what you're allergic to, there's one part of the coconut you should absolutely avoid at all costs, and I'm talking coconut water. I know, people have been treating coconut water like the next big thing in health and wellness, but the truth is you may as well just drink sugar water. It's that high in sugar. This little container has 3.5 teaspoons of sugar. And you know that myth that because it's high in electrolytes, it's great after you work out. Well, if you're a marathon runner or a triathlete or an Olympian, you can probably get away with using coconut water to rehydrate. But for the average Joe, even the fit average Joe, it's better to stick with nature's best hydration tool, water. And save that coconut water to use in your hair. It's actually great for keeping your scalp healthy and your hair strong. But what about coconut meat? Good news, coconut lover. As long as there's not a bunch of sugar added, coconut meat in all of its forms is actually pretty fantastic for you. You can stew chunks of coconut in curry sauce for a really satisfying broth. You can toss it in a stir fry or even blend it up with romaine and mint for a very interesting smoothie. The same goes for unsweetened shredded coconut. You can use it in baked goods, homemade granola, as a mix for ice cream, the right kind of ice cream, or on top of a little goat's milk yogurt for flavor. And if you can find these flaked coconut chips without added sugar, good news. They're a fantastic Plant Paradox approved snack. Just do me a favor and make sure you're reading the packaging your coconut products come in. A lot of them have added sugar to mess up your gut. Now, there's one other format that coconut meat comes in, and it's probably the most common way you'll see coconut in my cookbook and other books. And I'm talking about coconut flour. Basically, it's dried ground coconut meat, and you'll see it as a substitute for flour in a lot of my baked goods for a few reasons. First, because it's got a great flavor. Nutty, a little sweet, not over the top coconutty. Second, because it seriously absorbs liquid, so you don't need to worry about your baked goods falling apart. And third, because unlike wheat flour, it's not loaded in lectins, so it's good for you and your gut. Now, there are two other parts of the coconut that I actually use all the time. The first one's got a pretty strong coconut flavor. In my opinion, it's essential to certain dishes in my book because it adds sweetness and creaminess while boosting the health of the food you're cooking. I'm talking about coconut milk and its rich cousin coconut cream. In fact, most of the time I use coconut cream rather than coconut milk. It's higher in fat, lower in sugar, and the consistency is out of this world. I use it to add a nice creamy note to dairy-free ice cream, to braise greens, thicken stews, and of course as a rich base for curries. And every now and then I'll use it in my coffee, if I'm not in the mood to drink it black. Basically, it's my go-to when I'm making something new that calls for regular old A1 milk and cream, because it's got a similar texture, and I find the flavor goes well with just about everything, from desserts to the most savory dishes. And the other part of the coconut that I use a lot, coconut oil. Specifically, cold-pressed virgin coconut oil. Make sure it's solid at room temperature, not liquid. And let me start talking about coconut oil by saying, yes, I've read the recent studies saying that coconut oil is not as healthy as some people claim. And it's true. I'll be the first to say that eating coconut oil will not magically fix all your problems. But in moderation, it's actually pretty darn good for you. And if you're a vegan, it's a solid substitute for butter and baked goods. Just remember, coconut oil is not as great for your health as, say, olive oil or MCT oil or perilla seed oil. So it's one you should use in moderation. And as you've heard me say before, if you carry the ApoE4 gene, you are better off not using that much coconut oil. But coconut oil is certainly not something you should shy away from, even on the Plant Paradox plan. Now, there's one other question about coconut oil that I get all the time. Dr. Gundry, what if I don't like coconut? I always tell people there's very little required eating on the Plant Paradox, though I'd certainly encourage olive oil and leafy greens. So if you don't like something, skip it. If a recipe calls for chunks of coconut meat, try using sweet potato instead for the same slightly sweet, firm, meaty texture. Or give jackfruit a try. Just make sure it's not packed in syrup. And if coconut flour is on the menu and you're not allergic, I suggest giving it a try before writing it off. It's got pretty mild flavor. Still not a fan? Try cassava flour, green banana flour, or sweet potato flour. You can also consider almond flour. But remember, coconut flour acts as both a binder and a flour, so you may need to adjust your ratios a bit. Too much coconut flour can make food pretty dry. And when it comes to coconut milk, you can use A2 milk and heavy cream or unsweetened almond milk in its place. You can also make something rich and creamy like macadamia nut milk if you want. We're beginning to see that in stores. If you're not afraid of the color, you can swap a ripe avocado in for coconut cream in a recipe for a similar texture. Or a pureed green banana can add the same creaminess. Honestly, there are so many ways to eat on the Plant Paradox that you shouldn't ever feel like you're stuck with an ingredient you hate, even if it's as common as a coconut. Because I'm Dr. Gundry, and I'm always looking out for you.